There's a good chance your church sanctuary was not built with sound in mind. Or maybe you rent a gym, warehouse, or some other type of building that's not sound friendly. Either way, sound absorbing panels can definitely improve the sound at your church. The problem is they're expensive. So let's talk about how to cut the cost in half. This video is brought to you by Behringer X32 Mastery, the fastest way for church sound techs to master the X32. And with a team license, you can enroll unlimited team members now and in the future. Finally, everyone will be on the same page. Visit x32.church or click the link in the description to learn more. My church once met in a former grocery store. Every surface in the room was hard and flat. We had drywall, concrete floors, and plastic chairs. On top of this, the sanctuary was about twice as long as wide, giving it a hall-like effect. As you can imagine, this made for a sound nightmare. If you clapped your hands, the sound would continue for about 2 to 3 seconds. There was also a frequency range in the room that would reverberate 6 to 9 dB louder than the rest of the frequency spectrum. Feedback breeding grounds if the EQ isn't set just right. Shortly after we moved into this building, I began the journey of making our room sound better. After hours of working to get the EQ just right and days building and hanging sound absorbing panels, the room actually sounded pretty good. Before you hang sound panels, I recommend EQing your room because that alone may get you the result that you're looking for. I'll include a link in the description to a video where I walk you through how to EQ your room. Now, let's talk about how to build sound panels. But before we get started, always check your local building and fire codes to make sure these materials meet their standards. And if you're using a rented facility, always obtain permission before hanging sound panels. Step 1, download the materials list by clicking the link in the description. Step 2, head to Lowe's and have them cut the plywood to the size that you want. They charge a small fee, but it's worth it. For example, we made 2-foot by 2-foot panels, so each 4-foot by 8-foot plywood sheet was cut into 8 squares. The plywood is used as the backing to help the frame stay in shape. Now step 3, make a frame for each panel using furring strips, wood screws, and wood glue, and then attach that plywood backing with nails. Step 4, cut the mineral wool insulation with a utility knife so that it fits inside the wood frame. Step 5, cut the burlap fabric so that you have enough to cover the insulation and pull it around and staple it to the back of the frame. Step 6, when stapling the fabric to the frame, start by putting one staple in the middle of each side. Then continue stapling around while pulling the fabric so that it's snug but not too tight. Step 7, attach a picture hanger to the back of the frame and mount it on the wall. You may be wondering how many you need. And the answer is, every situation is different. ATS Acoustics offers a free online room acoustics analysis to help you determine how much acoustic treatment is needed in your room. It analyzes the aspects of the acoustics in your room using readily available dimensions and surface information that you provide. I'll include a link in the description to this tool. Now, ATS Acoustics also sells pre-made panels. It's gonna cost you about double compared to building them yourself, but if time is of the essence, this may be the way to go. If you have questions, be sure to drop them in the comments. I'd be glad to answer. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, give me a thumbs up to let me know. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the little bell so that we can let you know when a new video comes out. I'll see you next time.